All right, hello everybody. What is going on? Start one of those right over there. So, we got something a little bit new going on in the house tonight. Check this bad boy out right there. Is that something else or what? Look at this. So always something a little bit new. So, this here is just a... You want to see something really cool? Hold on, let me throw this on mute. By the way, Tone's compliment of the Black Widow... Black Widow. By the way, what's really interesting is that I have this piped into my T100, my power amp. You could see it on down there. See the Carvin Tube 100? And then I have the Tube 100 going into the torpedo captor, into the torpedo cab. So you're actually getting to hear this going through an all-tube power amp. And goddamn, it sounds great. So here's just the live sound. It's always going through the audio in when I play. So, you know, here's the sound. Well, you kind of got to hear it. So just a really nice, this was sent here by the good folks at Framus. This is a loaner. This isn't my guitar. Man, I'll tell you, I should start a new policy. Like if I love the thing, I'm going to keep it forever policy. Because this one right here is just, this is just stunning. This here is a Framus. It's a Panthera. It's a Pro Series. Actually, I think it's like a made in Germany. It's a team built. This one right here is a team built. So you could see on the back. I don't know how good I'm going to be able to get a close up there. But maybe at the right angle. It's probably about as good as it's going to get angle wise. Thank you. Rick Good said nice playing. Nice guitar rack. That rack, I'm telling you, that rack sounds really good. Tyler says, what did I miss? You didn't miss anything. I just started, actually. Let me throw this on standby. I just started, and one of the things I wanted to do was I wanted to come down here and just set some stuff up. An acoustic rig. I got some stuff from another company I wanted to share with you. And you know what? I'd rather do that sort of thing on camera. I'm all about transparency. Tyler Morris in the house. Dude, what's going on? I need to take lessons from that guy. Tyler Morris, we need to talk, man. It's B-Low. Yes, so we're supposed to be getting a storm I was actually supposed to be in New England tomorrow, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Every flight out of Newark was canceled. All the trains are canceled. So, what does the guitar go for? I don't know. It's a loaner guitar. It's not my guitar. Does not belong to me. So Tyler Morris, are you're up in New England, right? Are you bracing for the storm? Warren Salter, it's B-Lo, Dry Heat, Tyler Morris, Dan B, Tiny J Collins, full house, man, full house. So let me get some boxes. Let me show you a few things. By the way, this is the card that came with the guitar. This is, you could see over here, Framus Pro Series Team Built, the sound of wood. And this was built in July of 2017. And that's the model number if anybody's interested in it right there. That's the bad boy right there. It's got clear tones. Fretwork was tuned by Plec. So it could give you a nice little showing of what comes in the card or on the card. So B-Lo said, am I looking to get the new FR-FR from Headrush? No, I wish I would, but I have the altos, and it's funny because the Headrush is different than the altos. Bigger voice coil, it's really more designed for that. But mine are okay. Mine are okay. Everyone likes the Journey shirt. Cool. I'm glad you like the Journey shirt. So I've been getting a lot of things going with the new setup. I got the Beat Buddy down here. So we get like real drums. I don't have to touch anything with my hands. That's the Beat Buddy. Whip Junior says 7 days, no power. Yeah. Brian Savage, what's going on, my man? You get your new gear fix here? Nice. Well, I do have some new stuff. And again, I got a couple of things today. I actually, a couple of things were backlogged because of the storm. So everything showed up today. And again, I like to do this sort of thing live. I didn't want to wait till the weekend. Oh, by the way, a quick announcement. So a lot of people expressed interest in Black Widow. That was the preamp I did the video on this past weekend. And they are giving $100 off for the first 5 people that order. The coupon code is the Tone King, all one word. So if you are interested in that and you dig it, one of the things we said over the live webcast was that we would try to get you guys a discount code. So it's something, and if someone is interested in buying one, save $100. Great Van Zini in the house. Great Van Zini, it's funny you said you think you buy less by watching me. I was talking to my wife about that. I actually spent less money last year on gear than I typically have in past years. And I think I need to sell a few things. I need to focus on that this year. Just moving a couple of things, What do I think about ESP LTD guitars? I think they're great guitars. Dan of NJ, what's going on, man? So for the Northeasters in the house, you guys ready for the storm? They're saying another nor'easter. Rob Bird, that is a Malmsteen guitar. That is a Malmsteen. Hey Tyler, if Tyler Morris is still there, remember this guitar? I actually had him play this when we were at Groon's, and I said, "Dude, what do you think about this?" And he picked it up, and he was like, "Dude, ebony board, nice broken in feel." So I wound up buying it, and it's funny because Doug from Jet City was here last weekend, and he picked this up, and he said, "Oh my God!" He goes, he owns a studio, and he said this played a lot better than his studio. It's just got that real broken in feel. Tyler Gilkerson, looking to buy from you. Yep, this was the guitar from Groon's right here. And a lot of people like the guitar. It sounds good too. I think I paid like 800 for it. Well, maybe less, 750. You want to hear this one?
Yeah, I'll give you a quick go on this one right here. Where's my wireless?
Okay. It's probably a little out of tune. Let me tune this up real quick. Hang on. So that's the Les Paul, and for a relatively inexpensive guitar, again, this sells for, well, because it's used, right? This guitar is, it's just broken in. It's just a broken in guitar. But, it's not perfect, but it feels good and sounds good, and I guess that's kind of what you want in an instrument, right? Rob Sells says, why not use the rack tuner? I could, I'm just used to the Korg. You know, that's a Sabine RT7100. Truthfully, I just think the Korg is a better, it just picks the notes up better, it gives me more accurate reading. Should make a GitCon here stateside at Sweetwater. Well, you know, the thing is, Sweetwater kind of has their own thing already, right? They have Gear Fest, and now PRS is having an event, which I'm going to go to. It just seems like everybody's having their own event. I think the main difference is that, the nice thing about GitCon, it was just all focused around YouTube. That was kind of the main deal, right? Not everyone's doing that, but I think it was brilliant. DW Fan says, just watching an old TDK live stream with Steve from Boston. I got notified that you're live now. Awesome. There we go. Michael Smilek. So let me get a few boxes. I have a couple of boxes that showed up, and I want to open some stuff up. I'm drinking some brisk iced tea. I just like iced tea, I used to drink a lot of those monster drinks, and I'll tell you, I prefer just a nice cold iced tea, That is an ebony fretboard, Michael. The Blues Bunker, what is going on, man? Jerry B, what is up? Blaine Ludeman in the house. Awesome. Tonosaurus, one of those. There you go. Yeah. Looking 16 to 20 inches in mass. All right, let me get a box. Let's open some stuff up and check out some gear. Hang on. So here's the dealio. It's like Christmas morning. Where do we begin? All right. So this one here, this is a blast from the past. Okay. Ken Rich, what's up? I got to put my glasses on. I'm getting a little bit of a headache trying to read the small font. These are actually prescription glasses. I know they're tinted, but they look more tinted than they really are. I'm not trying to act cool with the sunglasses. I'm actually just trying to read the comments. You did not miss the news yet. Oh, Devin. Yeah. So $100 off. Anybody that may be interested in the Black Widow. Let me throw that on standby. $100 off. Coupon code the Tone King. Limited to 5 people. I'm sure if number 6 or 7 shows up, just send me an email and we'll call Brian at Black Widow and make it happen. But it's, you know, it's, we're trying to, you know, do 5. That was the dealio. Okay. Anybody remember this company right here? Earth 3. Skip De Palma. Hello from Connecticut. So Earth 3 was a company that was based out of Staten Island, New York. I didn't know they were based out of Staten Island, New York. But if you're from Staten Island, maybe you remember a place called Silver City on Forest Avenue. And that place used to carry Earth 3 guitar straps. I was maybe 12 years old. I used to go in the store. They used to have buttons for our denim jackets. They'd have the black bracelets for our wrists. Yeah, so Earth made guitar straps. Well, another guy from Staten Island wound up resurrecting the company. He and I spent the better part of an hour on the phone the other day just talking about Staten Island. And it was so exciting to hear that he brought back Earth 3, because Earth 3, I remember the guitar ads. I could probably pull one up, but Earth 3... Stevie Ray Vaughan used an Earth 3. You know, they were really popular. They used to spend a lot of money in advertising when guitar magazines were actually a big thing, right? And this one here, let's see how good everyone is. This one here is based off of a guitar strap that a very popular guitarist used in a very popular movie. Okay, so this is Earth 3. Oh, hang on. That's Earth 3 right there. Now, here's the dealio. What guitar strap was this from? Let's see. There we go. Yeah. James Geary says, sweet, bringing back some history. Anybody know who used this guitar strap? John Parsons said, hit the like. 200 people. Let's give some thumbs up, guys. Yeah, so Earth 3 was one of those brands. It was just like, man, I was so happy to see him come back. And they had all those real exotic 80 straps. Oh, man, Timothy, you got it right. Steve Vai and Crossroads. Who else said that? Johnny Rock, Shred Before Dead, Jack Butler. Actually, un-effing believable, said Jack Butler. Yes, this was Jack Butler's guitar strap. In Crossroads, and he was using the Earth 3 strap. This was the strap. Well, not the exact strap, but this is it. Yes, Skip De Palma says they advertised a lot in Circus. That's right. So the good folks at Earth, I had such a nice conversation. They said, dude, send us your address. We're sending you a strap. So this is my gift from Earth 3. And, you know, truthfully, I would have bought it. I mean, and in fact, I may buy a few of their straps. But it was very generous of them to say. We had such a great conversation. I'm 45. I was telling him stories of when I was 13 years old, and he knew exactly the stores I was talking about. That's a meaningful conversation. No, Jack Butler played a Charvel. I think it was a Charvel... It was like a Model 1, but it had the Floyd. So what was the single pickup with the Floyd? No, it was a Charvel. But I don't know the model. I'm not sure the exact model. Yeah, so this is the Jack Butler guitar strap. Wow, it's amazing that everyone knew that right away. Isn't that nice? And they have the Stevie Ray Vaughan guitar strap, lots of really cool stuff. So Earth 3, check them out. Let's see if we have, the website is earth3.com, E-A-R-T-H-T-H-R-E-E, like spell out the number 3. Showman Blues, we're just hanging out, man. I showed everybody my new Earth 3 guitar strap. The Jack Butler, Steve Vai Crossroads guitar strap. Oh, so Ron Padgett says it was a Jackson San Dimas. Okay, I thought it was a Charvel, which I guess makes sense because didn't they share the same headstock? Well, at least the Charvel model series shared that headstock. Okay, so it was a Jackson. I didn't know that. Okay, learn something new. Taped out to not stir any controversy. Oh, really? With the Michael Jackson family? Was there controversy with the Michael Jackson family and Jackson guitars? Ah, so according to Steve, that guitar was a one-off. Got a red with lightning bolt Earth 3 strap and black with note strap. Yeah, I'm gonna pick up a few more of these. I just like the brand. Brings me back. Matt's Music is making copies of them. Ron, can you send me a link? Can you send me an email? I'd like to check them out. Yeah, this is like a blood splatter design. Blood splatter. Earth 3. Yep. Yeah, it was a nice conversation, and they said, let me send you one over. So very, very generous of them. Okay, so I have a few other things here. Let's do this. So this here is by Mission Engineering. So the giveaway is probably the logo right on the... right on the box there. What fabric? I guess it's like a thick nylon. I don't know the exact fabric. I'm not sure. I would guess a nylon, but I'm sure it's on their website. I'm actually not sure. So I don't want to give anybody any misinformation. So by the way, I put a picture on my Instagram page. If you don't subscribe to my Instagram, you should, because I put a lot of cool pictures up there. And if you like this rack, one of the pictures I took from my Instagram page was a rack at Winter NAMM that had a Helix, a Kemper, an Axe FX, an 11 note, and maybe something else all in one rack. It was like insane. In fact, my caption on Instagram was something like, holy smokes, Batman, that's like a lot of modeling or something like that. And that was their company. This was their rack. So, two things here. This is thing number one. Let me put that right there. And this is thing number two. So let's start with thing number one. So made in the USA, and they make expression pedals for a lot of different companies. In fact, this expression pedal was made for check this out. Made by Mission for Line 6. And the reason why is I'm going to be covering some more Line 6 stuff. You know, I got Helix Native, but I'm going to play around with the actual Helix unit itself. Okay. And this here, or the HX FX. And this here, they make this expression pedal for Line 6. Okay. And, Mission Engineering, Petaluma, California, missionengineering.com, made in the USA. and they make that. They actually make pedals like this for a few different companies. Okay, real, just real high quality pedals. And there's a potentiometer in here. So that's not like the string or anything like that. That's actually moving a potentiometer. Sweep Freak, what's going on? Yeah, it's Bilo said, perfect for the Helix FX. Exactly right. So that's that. And then they also sent this, and it's a USB power converter, okay? And what this does is it allows you to take any USB, like these, what are they called, like juice boxes, and it upvolts them. I don't know. Let's see if the right word is here. Mission 59 is the world's first USB to effects pedal power converter. Connected to a power supply such as a wall charger, rechargeable battery pack, or a computer USB port, the 529 provides five isolated 9-volt effect power pedal power output. They could be chained together via USB link to power up to 10 pedals. Okay, so it's this. Check this out. So you could take something like this. See if I could give you a nice clear shot. 529 USB power converter. Okay. So think about this. You take a guy like, they also sent, wow, that's nice. There's a whole bunch of stuff in here. There's a mobile power pack by APC. And then, of course, all the cables, all the goodies. Let me show you. Now, if you take a guy like from Steve from Boston as an example, we all know he rocks a laptop like the what's his go-to software? What's his software that he always uses? I forget the name of it. But let's say he wants to use his laptop or his computer and pedals. You just use this. You plug this into your laptop or your computer because it's USB. And then you could plug some pedals into here and run that like in the front of your audio interface or something like that. So really convenient for, any sort of USB. You could daisy chain them with USB or just a juice box. If you want to plug in a juice box, power up some pedals, you're good to go. Certainly beats 9-volt batteries, right? You could charge one of those. As a matter of fact, I have one in this box right over here. Hang on. Let's get to box number three. TH3, thank you. Everyone's saying TH3, thank you. I'll show you everything in 1 minute. Let me just unload this real quick. Okay. So even if you wanted to use something like this, this is a rechargeable power station. Okay, and this has a few outputs that you could use. It also daisy chains. But you know, one of these type of things that are not made for pedals, you have for staples or whatever. That, you know, little iPhone like battery. They call juice boxes. You could also use that to power this bad boy up to power up your pedals, which is pretty cool. Yep. TH3. Yes, it was TH3. Thank you. So that's what's in from Mission Engineering, and I want to thank them for sending that over, okay, which I'm going to be doing some demos and stuff in some upcoming videos. And then here's some cool stuff. So, you know, I have the acoustic. Let's see how good you guys are. What's one of the things I mentioned about the acoustic when I was playing the acoustic? Does anybody remember? It was really about, oh man, I wish I had some pedals or something to really kind of you know, like almost like a preamp made, something made for acoustic. Remember that comment? The pedal note added some excitement. So I have this Studio Logic pedal thing down here, so I could you know, give a little background ambiance when I'm playing. You know, it certainly beats just playing over nothing, right? So these here, so check this out. These here are made by LR Bags. Check this out. So it's a reverb made for acoustic. Yeah, great Vanzini, like a fly rig acoustic, exactly. Right? So you get something like this, okay? And I have a few of them, but these are all for acoustic guitars. Let me show them to you. So that's one. And they make this whole series for acoustics. And I'm going to build a pedal board. I don't know if I'm going to build the pedal board today, but I will be building a pedal board, because I want to show everybody the pedal board. Two more. Look at this one. And again, this is all for acoustics. Okay. So I'm going to build an acoustic pedal board. I'll probably do it live, because I like doing things live. I don't like giving you a pre-recorded canned video. I like to do it live and hang out and talk and read comments and all that. Look at this, Active DI. So LR Bags, they really, you know, it's funny because this actually came from a friend that watches my videos and heard me make the comment of, dude, there's products out there that do exactly what you asked about, but I'm not really that big on acoustics, so I didn't know that. And he hooked me up with the LR Bags guys, and poof, here we are. So we're going to do some gold patch cables. Okay. Into a small board. I'm going to do a four pedal board into the Duo, the Rock Board Duo. So we're going to build an acoustic pedal board. So check this out. This comes in a bag, so you could bring your acoustic guitar and this. You could have your four pedals on here with also like a DI out. So if you want to go to a mixer or something like that, you could do that. Okay. There's a nice strap in here. Nice bag. Comes in a nice bag. Shows you how to put the tape on your pedals and all that stuff. How to set up your new rock board. Comes with tape. Okay. And of course, your mini pedal board, which is really light, by the way. It's very light. So, build an acoustic board. You got it all on here. You're good to go. You're done. So now you have something you could plug your acoustic in and just rock out. Sweep Freak says some odd topics are being brought up here tonight. So while I was showing you the new gear, what odd topics did I miss? Terry in the house. What's going on, Terry GGNG? Cheers, buddy. What's the conversation we're having this fine evening? Showman Blues got an 11 rack on sale for $349. Yep. Those have actually been on sale since Christmas. Sweetwater's been having that sale for a long time. Fezler in the house. X1 demo will be coming soon. In fact, I'm going to hook the X1 demo into the rack. Someone talking about your choice in mods. I don't even know what that means. Like amp mods? So I could take the output, because remember, I have this line mixer here. So I could take the output, plug it into the line mixer. The line mixer is going through my IntelliFX, my MIDIverb, my TSR-12. That goes right to a power amp. I could put that right through the torpedo, and you get to hear it like full bore, like how I would actually use it. What was the sub sound? That is a Studio Logic. You know what? I could probably connect my phone and give you another camera view. I could show you if you want to see it. So that's the beautiful thing about, let's see if, I could just add cameras live to the Sling Studio. And I'll do it right now. I'll show you what I have going on down over here. The battery's almost dying on here. But it'll be enough to show you what's going on. How's that classic ADA MP1 sound? Sounds pretty good. I could turn it on if you want to hear it. It's no big deal. It's all hooked up. You can see how messy my desk is. Hang on. Let me find my Sling Studio app. Here it is. So with my phone, you ready? Oh, there it is. All right, everyone ready? Here we go. Let's go for the tour. So this right here is made by Studio Logic. And if I just do something like this, the Beat Buddy over here. So got all that cool stuff over there. Lots of boxes over here. All you guys over there. More boxes over here of all the stuff I just unboxed. Oh, I'm sorry. Everybody's probably like, dude, there's no volume. So I started to say, Tyler Morris, you said, how much is that? And my question was, What specifically did you want to know the price on? But I started to say, if you want, just text me tomorrow. I'll be around. I could tell you what I have and you know, how I have it all hooked up and all that stuff. So just give me a ring. Nope, the chats are a little slow. Hang on, chats are a little slow. Yes, like organ pedals. Yep, sound should be back. It's funny, all of a sudden, all the chat's coming back. Okay, all good? Anthony Quintanilla just stopped in to say hello before you go to bed. Well, have a great night, dude. I'm not really a bass player. I do have a bass, although I wouldn't say I'm a bass player. But that is that, my friends. So I just wanted to get this camera, this thing going, just to show everybody what I had going on over here. I think that's all I have for you this evening. And again, this bad boy right over here, look at this. I should probably leave with a few riffs on this. Yeah, you know what? There's 200 people watching and 66 thumbs up. Do you think we could hit 200 thumbs up? What do you think? Before you leave, give it a quick thumbs up. And I'll give you a jam before we end this live show. Here we go. It would help if I took the preamp off standby. We'll be right back. So, an amazing, amazing instrument. Really, truly an amazing instrument. I'll tell you, I think the best things about Framus was just having learned about their instruments at GitCon. Here's the sad part. There was zero pressure for us to play anything that we didn't want to play. And I didn't play a lot of Framus. I wish somebody put the guitar in my hand and said, dude, play this. Their guitars truly are amazing guitars. They're amazing guitars. Look at those silver pinstripe lines under the clear coat. Gorgeous. Just gorgeous. Oh, check this out. Did you ever see this before? Look at this. Hold on. I need to use two hands. Check this out. Here we go. Did you ever see a back cover? It just snaps off just like that, and then it snaps right back in. Look at that wiring. I mean, is this crisp or what? Just amazing. Real crisp. Pops right on there. The neck joint, jeez. It's going to be like, they're going to be like, hey, Tone King, can you send your guitar back? And I'm going to be like, yeah, there's nobody home. You know, don't call me, we'll call you. I'll get back to you. Guitar's in the mail. You'll be like, yeah, it hasn't shown up yet. Remember the movie, remember the scene in Fargo? When they're like, yeah, well, we're still waiting for the VIN numbers. And he's like, yeah, they're on their way. One more riff. Here we go. There it is. There it is. Just, you know, it's funny. I was talking about my Les Paul and how broken in it feels. And I had to buy a used guitar to get the broken in feel. This feels broken in and it's brand new. It's, you know what I think it comes down to is just, you know, it's how they design a guitar, how they design an instrument. It's got the ratio tuners on here. You know, the guitar practically showed up in tune. Almost reminds me a little bit like of the Wolfgang. Let's do something clean. Hang on. Let me come over here. Let's go to a clean channel. Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry. I had the thing. I don't know what the scale is. Nobody likes that song, right? So, there's the song everyone hates to hear. There you go. So that's that. That's the guitar, the gear, the fun stuff. This is an amazing guitar. Made in Germany, team built. Look at the back. How did I not know about this? How did I not know about Framus until we went to GitCon? Maybe I should play a little Jack Butler. See what we could do. Something like that. I can't do the Jack Butler riffs. In fact, I think that's where Jack Butler screwed up, right there, right? I'll give you a little Van Halen. We'll be right back. All right. Putting the pick down. Unplugging the guitar. But yeah, I'll be using this one. I'll be checking this out. Just this is an amazing instrument. I'll tell you, I think this is a Les Paul killer. I mean, this is an amazing instrument. And I mean that in all due respect. But this thing is just, it's just looks good, sounds good, plays good. Got the broken in feel. All right. Oh, somebody wanted to hear the ADA MP1, right? Let me turn that bad boy on real quick. Okay, I'm going to turn the Black Widow off. We'll turn that on. And who wants to hear the ADA MP1 real quick? Anyone? Anyone? Beulah? Clark Burdett, what is going on? Here it is. It would help if it was plugged in. Hold your ears. There we go. Now, the MP1 sounds good, but if you've played through enough rack gear, you'll notice that, you know, some stuff sounds a little boxy. Okay, now compare that. Check this out. This is the Black Widow, and it just sounds a lot more fuller, open, more dynamic. Check it out. Thank you. So, there it is. Alrighty, folks. So, if Phil Smith just joined. So, that's a good question. Daniel Perkins says, do I ever feel overwhelmed by all the stuff I have? And the honest answer is I do. And sometimes a good solution to that is sometimes you got to sell a few things, right? I've been using Patreon for some of that stuff. Again, I'm not a fan of selling stuff publicly. As the Tone King, I've heard too many horror stories where it just opens a can of worms for stuff. So the nice thing about Patreon is it's very private, it's very intimate. I get to know the folks that tune in. We do a private live webcast. In fact, I have one next weekend coming up. So we're doing that. And, you know, like for instance, I was talking to someone today and I had a particular piece of gear in my rack, by the way. And I said, dude, if you want it, it's yours. Just name a price, whatever you think is reasonable, and it's yours. You know, it's just one of those, you know, not looking to make a killing on it. And if it's just, you know, the nice thing about Patreon is nobody's going to kill each other. I try to give stuff away at a good price. And, you know, name a price, you know, that type of thing. So I've been doing that with Patreon a little bit. I do have a reverb store. But again, it's not called the Tone King. I just don't want to be associated with selling stuff because that's not what this is about. Sometimes when you sell stuff as the Tone King, people get the wrong idea. And next thing you know, you're on chat boards and forum boards of, oh, I didn't like this. I didn't like that. I just don't need the gossip or the drama. So, but I did want to sell some stuff because a lot of times when I sell something, I'm not looking to make a huge, you know, profit on it. I'm just looking to let it go to a decent price for somebody that's truly interested. And I think there's about 10 people, 12 people on Patreon that I've been offering stuff up to. You know, cheap pedals for 10 bucks a piece. I had something in the rack that I offered up. And stuff like that. It just gives me an outlet to say, hey guys, who wants it? You know, who wants this sort of thing? And, you know, just did enough to make it want to go. So that's kind of how I've been selling stuff. RMG says, I haven't heard your thoughts on the PR Silver Sky. Do you have feelings one way or another? I think it's awesome. I mean, I think it looks great, and I bet you it plays great, too. You know, like, whatever. Yeah, it looks like a Strat, but whatever. You know, I think legally, the Strat design, minus the headstock, I think it's public domain. Anybody could make it. So it's fair game, man. And you know what? PRS will do it better than anybody out there, so why not? You know, what's guitar in the back right? Oh, the Vola, the black one. Showman Blues said that's pretty smart. The less drama, the better. Michael Smilek, thanks, buddy. You take care. So anyway, that's the outlet I've been using to sell some of the stuff I sell. And then, of course, I sell some stuff privately, some old pedals. I actually sold two guitars recently on Reverb, but again, not as the Tone King because, you know, just people start coming to conclusions and that's not my goal, you know. But anything I've sold on Reverb publicly, as myself, not as the Tone King, I've always offered up to Patreon first. And again, that was one of my outlets to do that. I actually felt really bad because there was one item that somebody wanted and I wound up not selling it just because I feel like I would regret it. But it's funny because I offered this individual something else. I said, dude, if you want it, it's yours. Just whatever price you think is reasonable, it's yours. Truthfully, the guy could have come back, said 50 bucks, and I would have sold it to him. And again, that's the nice thing about the Patreon. It's just the honor system. There's no trolls. Trolls don't pay money. So it's all about the honor system, and I gotta respect it, you know. What's up for the rest of the week? You know what? Showman Blues, it's a great question. And I, you know, the money that I do make, I actually put some of that back in this year. I spent well over $1,000 on the Sling Studio. I've been using that on all my live webcasts now. I get a good camera. I get multi-camera. So now what I used to have to do, like canned and edited, now I get to do live. It's the same quality, and I love that. So when will I fire up the next live show? It could be any time. Subscribe, hit the little bell so you get notified, and if I'm live, just come hang out. I will tell you this, it's always at night. I got three kids. I gotta wait till they're in bed to keep the second floor nice and clear, so I keep them all two floors above me, you know, a floor separated, right? This way you'd hear the dogs and the kids and all that. So it's always at night. But the agenda, I'm going to build the acoustic pedal board, okay? I'll play a little bit more of this bad boy right here before it has to go back. Even though I'm going to try my hardest not to send it back, but I don't think I'm going to win that one. This is it's a big investment instrument right over here. And build the acoustic stuff. I'm going to use my Jack Butler strap, Earth 3. Some Mission Audio stuff. And by the way, so here's an announcement. If you hung out this long, thank you for hanging out. So I'm gonna give you a quick announcement here for those that decided to stay a little late. So I'm not going to Summer NAMM this year. I have mixed thoughts about it. In fact, this is probably something I'm gonna talk about on the Patreon, but I'll give you guys a little sneak preview here. You know, Summer NAMM is a big expense for me, and I lose money. It's a lot of fun, but it's you know, when I go to Winter NAMM, nobody's paying me to be there. When I go to Summer NAMM, nobody's paying me to be there. You know, Winter NAMM is about $2,000 out of my pocket. Summer NAMM is about $1,500 out of my pocket. So it's just a lot of money, and I just don't get a return out of it. It's not like, you know, people are doing more like, hey, let's do a project, let's do this. Like, I don't get more out of it. And being that now those shows are so flooded with people with cameras, it's like my value prop isn't as great as it used to be. So I'm going to do some different stuff this year. I'm going to go to Line 6. We're going to do like a behind the scenes at Line 6, which is really exciting. So I have an exclusive on that. I'll go to the PRS Experience, which I've never done, so I get to bring new and exciting content to all of you. So PRS, Line 6, of course we're going to do GitCon again. I think those are going to be my three guitar events this year. I'm going to pass on Summer NAMM, and, you know, we'll hit Line 6, we'll hit PRS, and we'll hit GitCon. So those will be the three things this year. And again, I'm just trying to spend the money a little bit better. This way, you know, I'm not just, you know, shoveling out money, because it seems like whatever comes in goes right back out, you know. So just trying to be a little bit more smart about things. Alrighty, folks, that's all I have for you. We're about an hour and 15 minutes in. So I wanted to thank everyone for kind of hanging out this fine evening. And, you know, that's about it. So thank you. Rock on. And I will see you later. Don't forget to hit, give me some thumbs up on the way out, subscribe, and hit that little bell icon, and you'll be notified next time we go live. So thank you, rock on, and we'll see you later.